Now, things are clearly fluid right now, and school leaders are asking for your patience.
Decision-making for school districts is complicated by a lack of scientific research about how the virus spreads in schools. And we continue our coverage tonight with a breakdown from Denver 7 investigator Jennifer Kovaleski. She talked to the experts who were crunching the numbers.
This line is dictating how we live.
We're acting in real time with the data we have.
As coronavirus cases went up, restrictions grew with it.
Remember, we had a peak early to mid-April.
When we finally bent the curve, we saw a new kind of normal. Now we're fighting again to keep the virus at bay.
There's a rise in case counts.
While the data is shaping how we respond, there are no clear metrics for how students go safely back to school.
I wish we had the data we need.
Dr. John Zammit leads Colorado's COVID-19 modeling team, the expert researchers behind that line.
When the pandemic hit, schools were closed down, so we don't have very much data, very much observation about what happens with schools.
Data from around the world clearly shows children are far less likely to get seriously ill from the virus. But the big unanswered questions are how often children become infected and what role they play in transmitting the virus.
We're having a big experiment. I'm hoping this works, that we learn by doing and we learn how to keep children safe, the adults who work in schools safe.
Zammit says schools will have outbreaks, but we don't yet know how many outbreaks is too many.
Probably end up making these decisions about how many outbreaks or how many affected children are too many, a little bit by the, quote, seat of our pants.
He says what will be key is contact tracing and watching the numbers closely.
If we see a rise that leads to projections of unacceptable numbers of cases, the answer is going to be we're going to have to find ways to increase social distancing, whatever's driving.
Governor Jared Polis says the most important guideline they want all schools to follow is cohort isolation.
Fancy word, but what that means is if there's a class of 25, they need to not interact with other classes of 25.
What is the worst case scenario with schools reopening?
Really bad worst case scenarios is that we have an overlapping flu on top of our COVID-19 epidemic.
Another concern is the potential for kids to get infected, many with no symptoms, and then spread the virus to adults in the school.
And then, of course, just how having schools open may drive up the epidemic curve.
What we do know is that as schools reopen in Colorado, all eyes will be on this line, and we don't yet know where it will take us.
I think we need to be prepared to avoid another shutdown.
I'm Denver 7 investigator Jennifer Kovaleski.
And for the teachers, so many have been vocal about how unsafe they would feel if kids were back in the classroom 5 days a week. And of course, with more than 55,000 teachers in our state, just like for the districts, it's not a one-size-fits-all solution here. Teachers, of course, come from all different backgrounds. They are all different ages and ethnicities, different health conditions. They live in different cities. They teach different subjects. And that's why so many have differing opinions.
The parents aren't gonna see her walking around and looking at the kids' work and, you know, leaning over their shoulder and discussing their paper with them and getting down on their knees, you know, and patting them on the back and all of those like personal touches and all those things that it takes to teach really well.
Safe contact, in my view, is better than no contact.
You can watch our complete 360 report and hear from more teachers right now on thedenverchannel.com.